Hey guys, just getting ready to take Gage out for a run around the 90-acre trail. My Noco Boost Plus came in the mail today. I wanted to show it to you guys because this is going to be a lifesaver. This thing weighs like a pound and it has 1,000 amps. You know that big Stanley 18 kilogram battery that I carry around and boost all my machinery with? This replaces it right here. So I wanted to show you guys, it has USB in, USB out. The only thing that I can see that's a little, that I don't really like about it is the USB chargers, like the old USB 2 is how you charge it. So it's kind of slow. I don't know why they wouldn't have at least used USB-C, and then you could use like a fast charger for your phone or something. But I'm not sure, I haven't read the manual how many hours this thing takes to charge, but oh, for the size of it, this is going to be a lifesaver. I want to show you guys what it came with and something else I bought to hook onto the snow machine and leave there. So this is the package that it came with. Came with a carry bag, came with a lighter plug, so I guess you could charge it right in your vehicle. There's the manual. Who needs that, right? So then you've got booster cables that plug right into the boost pack. So, you know, you could hook your four-wheeler or whatever you want up to that, no problem. This is the charging cable that it came with to charge this unit. Now, for $26, I also bought this. This is a system that you would wire directly onto your snow machine, four-wheeler, whatever machinery, right? It's going to hook right up to your battery. You're going to run it out the back. This plugs right into the end of the Boost Plus, the same as these cables do. So if you have one of these on your machine, you just plug this directly in and you boost it from here directly. That's what I'm going to do with the snow machine because the battery is under the seat. Now this cable for $26 also came with an adapter on it. And this I think is for the Noco charger. So this is a Noco booster. You can also get like a charger. And this cable comes with the adapter for both for $26. So I think this was $158 on Amazon, and you would probably get on a snow machine, I'm going to say 8 to 10 boosts on a full charge. So fantastic. I'll show you what it's replacing. Here's my Stanley booster with 1,000 peak amps, but 500 amp instant starting power. So that little lithium pack might actually have more kick than this. Now this is 8 or 9 years old. It still works all right. I just charged it the other day, but it is heavy. Oop, probably weighs, I'm going to say 25, 30 pounds. The only thing that this one is going to do that the lithium won't safely is hook into my solar system. So out here in the garage every summer when my heavy duty batteries, one is in the boat, one is in the 12 foot trailer, I hook this up to my solar system so that I can still charge my metal detectors and all my drills and things like that. And I also use it to charge other batteries. So this, all I do is I clamp these directly onto my solar system. So I may still have a use for the old Stanley. Could we do that with the lithium system? You know, will it charge the lithium batteries through the boost cables? I'm not sure. I'd have to read the manual to find out. But I think because I already own this, we're not even going to bother. We'll just use, this will become part of the solar system. I had a couple people comment before how organized I am. Guys, that took an hour to do. And you know how many hours that will save you when all your tools are there and you've got them all numbered or labeled across the top, you know? It's just, oh, it's so time saving. Do yourself a favor, take an hour and set yourself up something organized. That stems from working beside my dad for 20 years, living at his place. And him yelling at me, run down and grab me whatever wrench. And everything was just scattered willy-nilly in 8 different toolboxes throughout the basement. You know, some of them in water, some of them not. Gary's organized. So there's my only complaint. There's the charging port. And I haven't even charged it yet. So is it a valid complaint? I don't know. I mean, it seems like a pretty good system. If it takes a couple hours to charge this up, yeah, so be it. Thank you. So it's only minus 10 right now. I'm pretty sure the snow machine will start. But I have had to boost it about 5 times this year already, so hooking that cable into the back is not going to be a bad thing to do. So as you can see, the mice have already chewed a hole in my pouch here at the back where I keep all my spare belts and my tools and tie downs and stuff. But we're also going to have, I dropped the screw that holds the seat in place down inside there somewhere. We're also going to have to find a way to run those two cables out the back and then through this pouch, and then I'll tighten all that up. So then the booster, we can just open this, plug the booster right in here, not have to undo the seat every time. That's the plan. Let's see if the machine starts. It should, but because I've said that, now it won't. Exactly, now it won't freaking start. Hey, well, look at that. There's already a hole right here, so we don't have to drill anything. We can just run our cables right through there. But this is why I haven't swapped this battery out previously, because it's such a pain in the you-know-what to get all these cables off of here. I'm gonna have to undo this whole strap, I think, to get that out. But I've had it. Enough is enough. We're gonna swap that battery. We're gonna hook up that boost cable to it. And I'm not gonna screw around with it anymore. It's gonna be fixed. All right, so it wasn't as bad as I thought. We just had to undo the two bolts up there and then unhook the battery. So out with the old, in with the new, and in with the new charge system. I'm just gonna test this battery first, see how much voltage is actually in it. And then we're gonna throw it on the charger and see if we can revive it. Maybe it's just not being driven enough. The battery might still be all right. It's just not, even at a couple hours, every couple of days, it's not putting enough charge in here with the cold, so the battery might still be okay. Well, 11.89 is what it's sitting at right now. We'll throw it on the charger overnight and see if we can get it to accept a charge and hold it. I fully charged this one about 9 days ago, and just from sitting here in the cold, it's down to 12.3. Should be more than enough to get the machine going and run. We're gonna run the machine for a couple hours today, so. Which always leads me to the question of, is that Articat got something wrong with the charging system that it's not charging the battery enough? Either way, it's not gonna matter now that we've got the booster. Cause I don't care, we'll just boost it every time. If I don't have to take the seat off, and we can just plug a booster in and away we go, I don't care. So the new battery actually has the proper size blocks to screw into, so you don't have to hold the screwdriver underneath it when you're trying to screw it in there. The old battery had these little half blocks, and the problem is they don't sit high enough. When you try to screw in from the top, the screw won't reach into the block. But that being said, I do not throw anything out. I will keep these because you can stack them too high and they will still work. So that's Gary's tip for the day. Don't ever throw anything out. Eventually, you're going to need something. I keep every little piece. I've got multiple, multiple little plastic bins like this. Full of junk, my wife says. And then the old man burns a spring off the snow plow, and Gary's got to make a spring, right? Well, that's where I got it, out of my junk pile. That's where that spring came from. All right. Okay, so we've got our charge cable. I actually decided to put the positive and negative through each of their own holes. Run them through the back, and there, the plug-in is coming out our tool pouch. Perfect! Oh, what's that, Mr. Reed? Your machine won't start? Boost cable hanging out the back. Let's do this! Okay, so let's just try that battery. It should have enough power in it to start. Make sure all my tools are out of the way. Okay. Pump sounded like it had lots of power. Hey, hey, hey! May the snowmobiler in your life always find you handsy. Well, I looked down in there for that lost screw for the seat. It's gone somewhere, I don't know. So we'll have to find something to put in there, because now I won't have to undo the seat anymore. Well, first one, let's see. Let's see how lucky Gary is. Oh, I think that's gonna fit. I need two hands, but yeah, that feels about right. Look at that. Everything's working perfect today. All right, Gage and I are gonna go collect the trail cameras. So I need to grab the two trail cameras, but I also got in poo-poo from my wife because that dream catcher that I lost last night, apparently my daughter made that for her. I was unaware. Now I can see a little better. I don't know where it went. Gage took the stick and the dream catcher fell off somewhere. So I was just taking that trail camera off. Up there is where he stole the dream catcher from, and I found it. There it is. Redemption, maybe? Get out of here. You already got me in trouble. Two trail cameras and a dream catcher. That's a successful trip right there. With the new battery installed, I noticed that the RPMs are dropping right down to where they should immediately. So, is the computer in the Articat smart enough to know that there's low voltage, not give you a low voltage warning, but ramp up the RPM to try to charge the battery? If that's the case, that's a terrible system because, like I said, you can't put this machine in reverse when the RPMs stay up that high. And also, as soon as you get off, the machine's wanting to go down the trail with nobody touching it. So, I would assume for safety reasons that's not the case, but as soon as we swapped out the battery, it seems to be working fine. I saw Lise, Dave's wife, coming down the trail on my trail cameras the other day, and I knew what she was doing. She had no trespassing signs. So we're back at the corner where I suggested maybe we put a gate across here, because all of our trails from here on are all private. So they've remarked everything. You know, part of me wants to say, geez, that's gonna work. I feel good about that, but we all know what happens, right? People see the signs, they just don't care. So hopefully this works. It is marked. And now we can at least, you know, pursue further action by saying, hey, you were warned. People are just ignorant. Well, we were gone 45 minutes. And when I got it in the mail, it was on the second bar. So it's working on the last one right now. Not bad.